What is good, everybody? Chief Doggo here. This is a quick intro to the intro. This video is not going to be as good as the last one, man. I just try to enjoy my time while in Vegas. But we plan on going back, man. We're trying to go to see UFC 306. So, you know, this one is not going to be as good as the last one, but it's still a banger. So thank you for watching, man. Go look in the description for whatever.
What is good, everybody? Chief Dog tuning in from Las motherfucking Vegas. We're already here at the B&B. I didn't waste no time recording any of the drive here because, you know, it's not video worthy, but this place surrounding the B&B is kind of a dump, but the inside of the B&B is not too bad. So we're about to go check that out right now. We're here for UFC 300. So let's have a good time, guys.
All right, this is the inside. We got some type of like closet thing right here.
Yep.
The motherfucking living room, kitchen. Table, my bed. We have like 1,000 people come into this Airbnb. Somebody else's room, bathroom, and the other room. Nothing, you know, too glamorous, but we're gonna make it motherfucking work. We're gonna get drunk as shit in here. We're gonna fucking game and stream. So, once we make a move, guys, I'll come back at you. Right now, too much on the agenda. You know you can't have a trip to Vegas without the bevies, so we got that, and all those. Oh, we got these bad boys too. Tree! We're bound to have a good time. We can't drop none of these bottles from us. I'm really gonna kill myself. T-Sauce and a few others just vids. Pulled up. Hella vids.
What the fuck?
My bad. Right now, we're just plotting on what we're gonna do. We're gonna for sure hit the Bacchanal later. And then after that, I don't fucking know. Right now, I don't know what time it is. Can't check, but we're gonna do something.
We got the boys that pulled up with the cushy, wooshy. Shit smell fucking bank right now.
Me and Hayden just shared a twin last night.
Well, I smell good, bro.
And then, like I said, we got fucking hella bevies. Thoughts on the beverage count?
I'm thinking we started off here.
Dude, I was like this.
With the Bacardi in this motherfucker.
Like, fuck no, baby. It's only like 3 o'clock.
Shot o'clock.
All right, everybody. We finally decided what we're gonna do. We're gonna make our way to Caesar's Palace. Half of us, or more than half, took motherfucking Uber. Yandel's staying behind, and three of us are walking. So it's about like a 46-minute walk. Nothing crazy. Got the motherfucking hiccups again. Fuck. Finally made it to the strip after, you know, a couple minutes walking. It took us less than an hour, but the sun's beaming right in my goddamn face, so I'm starting to get a little bit sweaty and hungry. You know, luckily our lunch reservation at the Bacchanal, it's only an hour away, and we're like right here basically on the strip. Guys, here at the motherfucking food court at Caesar Palace. We're waiting for our fucking reservation at the Bacchanal, bro. Fucking whole ass hour from now, so I don't know what the fuck we're gonna do. If I'm hungry, and that's it, I might as well get something before a little appetizer to Bacchanal. Psych. If you just watched the other video, you might have a little bit of deja vu, because Chief Dog was hitting another blinker in Caesar's Palace at the food court. Here we go. Yo, what's up? UFC 300 press conference is going on. I should have been there, but I didn't know that was going on. I thought it was Nate Diaz versus Jorge Masvidal press conference, and I just did not give a shit, guys. So, we're missing UFC 300 press conference. Fuck me. Wait. Tony Brundage by slam knockout. 2 times in a row. Finally about time we head to the Bacchanal. Our reservation is pulling up, or time is coming up anytime now. About 20 minutes, but you know, we're gonna get there a little bit early. Here we are, guys. Motherfucking Bacchanal. Guys, I'm getting Golden Corral vibes. What about you, John?
This is the greatest buffet I've ever fucking
seen. We are now in line. I don't know how long this is gonna take, though. Hopefully not too long, bro, I'm hungry.
Guys, my first plate was a bowl of red menudo. This shit's like 9 out of 10, 10 out of 10. Some rice. It's cold, so not that good. Oh, it is good, but it's cold. so I don't know what to give it. I haven't had the tacos yet. We'll report back. But this is my first plate. All right, guys, now I got some Filipino barbecue pork skewers, some duros with some salsa molcajete, some mac and cheese, and a slider. This mac and cheese is pretty good, and this pork is pretty good. I'm about to try the rest of it right now.
All right, now we're really about to try it. Some butter. I'm not fucking with that.
I don't know what plate I'm on, but I'm starting to get full, guys. Brisket, mac and cheese, blinker. We're gonna have some dessert.
This isn't my final plate. I just want to try some of the dessert real quick before I actually head on to the final plate. Valid?
No plate, that's your bout.
What's better, Oscars or Bacchanals?
What's your shit called? Baca what?
Bacchanals.
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 Your guess. The show.
Valid?
Nope.
Valid?
Valid for show.
Valid?
Good, man.
All right, guys, 20 minutes left, and we're all feeling the fucking effects of all the food, but we're about to go for a final push and get as much food as possible in our belly before we go. Dessert review.
Get this motherfucker out.
Thank you.
All right. Berry cheesecake on the motherfucker. A little bit of everything. That's solid, bro. Sweet, creamy.
Wait, try the donut again.
Some sort of ube pudding.
That's just pretty good.
It's good?
Yeah. I didn't like it.
I like ube, though. The texture is nice.
Yeah, you're not fucking with that.
I mean, it is good, still, but
it kind of tastes like Lucky Charms.
Same thing, but Oreo in this motherfucker.
Ah, so this looks.
Alright. Japanese coffee bullshit.
Oh my fucking god. Use your both your hands, Barnold. Get deep. Yep.
Smells like dark chocolate, bruh. I'm not sure. Gash. 10 out of 10, bruh.
All right, overall plate rating?
Ass, good. That's a 40%, bruh. That's a fail.
No plate of the night. Menudo. Finished dinner at the Bacchanals. That show's fire. Man, I don't know. I'm too like fucking clouded in my brain from all the food to know. But I do know I'm full of shit. And we're going to Dave's Hot Chickens right now. Not to eat, but to meet up with the boys. Alright, guys, so out here in the Vegas wild, we just found a brick of weed.
It's a fucking brick weed right there, bro. They got the fucking bonfire going.
What the fuck?
Check it, bro. Look here.
Oh, he just smoked that shit. Dude, that's a fucking like narco brick right there, bro. We're here at the fucking B&B. I'm on shot number one. First one I took was like triple this or double it. Just like a half little baby shot. Everything's but at an AMG. I got a fucking pretty thick cup.
Chicken taco!
No, we're not a drinking channel, so we got the motherfucking chaser right here.
Might be right. Dude, no.
Oh.
Diego.
All guys. Night one was a success. I actually didn't get too drunk. A couple shots. And then I was just vibing. I went to sleep. Today's the day I plan to really get... I really plan to get drunk tonight for show. But I'm just waiting in the bathroom and get ready. All right, we're showered and we're ready to go for whatever, but right now we're about to hit this motherfucking blinker for my boy Penn, or no, for my boy Chillaxin. Gonna cut. This is, what flavor is this, Frankie? Tell me about this.
Coming out his nose and shit.
All right, fuck you.
And then we pulled over like two more times after that. He was like, yeah, I'm good. 10 minutes later. Wait.
Ooh, first smoke of the day.
So bad, too. Like, he almost threw up.
Alrighty, everybody. So right now we got a move. We're gonna go to the dispensary. I'm called New Leaf and pick up a little package. Myself, I'm getting like a 3 packs of edibles, which I'm gonna save for UFC 300. Maybe I'll take like 100 grams or milligrams for PFL and then 200 tomorrow. And then we'll get fucking super lit. All right, guys. So we're here at McDonald's. Not about to order anything, I don't think. Maybe, who knows? While we're waiting for our plug to hit the dispo. Just got back from the dispensary. Got myself my 3 bags of edibles. We're gonna eat the watermelon today for PFL. I don't know if it's gonna hit because it's just 100 milligrams, but the 200 should hit for show. We're not gonna eat this till later until it's about PFL time, which we're gonna go to. It's morning two.
Dude,
still at the B&B.
And
for me. I still got a what's it called? I'm about to take a shot right now. First shot of the day. No chasers, but I got the candy. It's gonna fucking suck. And I got my water too.
Get over it.
Get over it.
This is bad. This is bad. This is bad.
Yeah.
Jager, you're good.
At least, yeah, we gotta keep it rolling until tomorrow.
Oh my god.
I'm fucking dead.
Worst show
I've ever done in my life.
Got some mids. It's like a whole ounce. Hold on. Oh fuck. This is some of what we're smoking on. We got a ginormo joint. Sign down 8.
Let's find out.
A thumpa joint. The ultimate fucking weed gusher.
We're just gonna paint this motherfucker.
Alright, you can't fucking
a little icing. Do a little icing drizzle.
Like 3 shots deep. Now I'm about to smack the edibles. Here's a close up. Shit, glistening.
How many shots do you need? What are you doing?
Definitely tastes like watermelon, but it's not a strong flavor at all. So not bad. I give it like a 6.5 out of 10.
Six of them.
These are the squad tweaking.
Six of the shots.
For me.
Here.
Edibles. Initial bite tastes like watermelon, but then the more you get into it, the weed taste really comes out. So I bring that score down to a motherfucker like 5.
Get more hype.
Oh, right, guys, I just had one of the...
Nah, not fucking that.
A couple shots deep, I'm feeling pretty good. I don't really feel the drink yet, though. I might have to take another one in a little bit. I'm feeling pretty chill, though. I need more edibles. All right, we're on the way to Raise the Cane's right now. I really haven't recorded any of the joints we smoked, but it's only been like 2. And none of them have been nothing crazy, so you guys didn't really miss out on much, but we're smoking one right now, so we'll get some footage of that. Walking right now. I don't know what road this is. It's getting faded and shit. I'm like a couple shots deep, like about 5, 6, something like that. But they're like half shots because I'm not a drinker. I'm not trying to get fucking drunk in the day. I'm saving the real drunkenness for tonight.
A couple minutes later, we make it to Lost. Or no, what the fuck? Raising Cane's. I'm retarded. It was the classic box combo. It's time for dessert now. I already slammed a couple of these. Like, I just slammed four. I'm about to slam the rest of them right now. All first bag down. Let's go. All right, we're here at Virgin Hotels. I guess PFL is right in here, so let's go. The lobby's looking pretty good so far. Nice and clean in here. PFL today, UFC 300 tomorrow. It's about to be fucking lit. No, we don't got no shooters on us, but it's all good. We're gonna save that for tomorrow. Blinkers inside Virgin Hotels. We made it past the metal detectors. We got free posters. I think these are signed. Yeah, I think they're signed for the first 300 people. Let's fucking go. They're not doing this shit at UFC. There's the, what's called? The ring, the octagon that they're gonna be fighting in. All right, guys, these are the seats that I paid for. I'm gonna try to move this seat I didn't pay for later. We'll see. But they're not bad at all, man. I actually enjoy this view. We're gonna wait for the fighters to come out now. I'll record some walkouts and a little bit of the fights when it comes to it.
Virgin Hotels, Las Vegas. We are just moments away from go live on ESPN Plus for our first fight of the night. We've got Sean O'Connell, Tyrone Woodley, and Brandon Couture, Cage Side, just finishing up the pre-show. And we will be live around the world on ESPN Plus. So,
all right, hold on.
Make some noise. You're gonna see.
All right, guys, so we're about to sign some paperwork and we'll see how it goes. I think we're about to have a crazy opportunity right now. Bro, shout out to fucking Dual Wipes, man. We got some free fucking seat upgrades. Free as fuck, man. The first fight the boss starts.
He went in fishing at 246 and 1/4 pound. Sure. Brazil.
Shout out to fucking Dude Wife, baby. If you don't already fucking know, now you fucking know. Bro, take down the old fuck now. Knock his ass out. Knock his ass out, Lou. First fight ended in a sub. Like I said, guys, completely free, completely random. This shit's crazy. I was going for USA, guys, but I realized that he's, you know, jiu-jitsu practitioner, so I'm going for Alvin, whatever his last name is. Let's fucking go. The first round was actually really good, too, and the ring girl is bad. Oh my god! Flying fucking knee knockout in the third fucking round! Oh my god! That's fucking crazy! Yo! Wow! That's... My god, bro, that was fucking brutal. The sound of that in real time was nasty. Oh my god.
Yeah!
Guys, right before the co-main, or no, right after the co-main ended, Gilbert Burns, Herbert Burns, and fucking Gregory Rodriguez, RoboCop, fucking pulled up and it's right in front of us, bro. I got a picture with RoboCop and Gilbert Burns. The PFL event was a dub for sure. All the fights are over. The last fight ended in a first round finish. Very, very fast. Sean Strickland's right in front of me.
Alright guys, it's now morning of day number 3. I didn't get too drunk last night either after the PFL event. I was pretty tired, so you know, we just hung out a little bit and then went to sleep. So today has got to be the crash out day for me. You know, last 2 days have been pretty chill, you know, nothing to complain about, but I'm trying to get really fucked up today, so I'm trying to make that happen. We're about to go get some food right now. Not me, I'm not hungry, but we're about to slide to Mr. Fry's, man. UFC 300 starts in about like 2.5 hours or something like that, or at least the gates open, but we'll be there here in a little bit. Here at Mr. Fry's, man. That's the chili dookie fries.
I'm here.
I'm fine. They actually look good, but they also kind of look like diarrhea on top of fries.
You know,
I'm fucking with that garnish. Alright guys, here's the fresh out the fryer.
This
fry right here is like already covered in chili, so it's gonna be a little soggy. I'm gonna dig back for another one. So
you didn't wanna listen though. You didn't wanna listen. I think he was trying not to look like a little bitch in front of his girl. So he was like don't tell me what
the fuck. It's really good. If it had beans,
but he was like, he would like
that shit fucking absolutely destroyed me. Boom. Food is good, but I'm full.
This is Tony.
And so we just left Mr. Fry's, man, had some good food, and now we're about to go to the B&B real quick and then head towards the T-Mobile Arena. Got this bitch packed out. Guys, now leaving the Airbnb. Hop in the Uber, we're about to T-Mobile Arena, and I'll update you when we get there. Caesar's Palace. I think this might be my first time actually here this trip, but you know, I'm not tripping about it. We're having a good time without coming to the strip. And I'm about to slam these edibles. John, you trying to record me?
Yeah.
Right. Take three right there. That's three down, a couple more to go. I finished the peach gummies, you know, 6 out of 10. I wasn't really fucking with them. I mean, they're not bad, but you know, it is a mild flavor when you first chew them, and then the weed flavor comes out. So, you know, but they're not like horrible. It's time to try the fruit punch ones now. We're just walking around the forum shops right now, bullshitting, and you know, let's waste some time until the event starts. Now I'm about to open, I already got the fruit punch open right here, so we can save ourselves a little bit of time. Here, you guys can see what they look like. I'm about to try right now. Better than a peach. Guys, I should have known better, man. This shit tastes like ass. You know, the first initial bite with all this shit seems good, but after that it just goes down the drain. So we're gonna try finish this bag off as fast as possible, avoid all unnecessary shit taste. Blast of the 200 milligrams right here. Let's just stop right now. Come on, guys. That's it, bro. So, out of the three, I'd say my favorite is probably the watermelon. Because when I was like speed eating the watermelon one, it wasn't releasing that much, you know, weed flavor. But this straight up tastes like medicine with weed. So, you know, it's good. Don't buy these. Don't buy this flavor. Buy the watermelon peach. And now we're walking to the T-Mobile Arena. 200 mg down the hatch, which is really nothing. So let me boost that up with a blinker. Light work, no reaction. Inside the fucking Caesar's Palace, and dude, it's a fucking beautiful ass day right now. It's the best day it's the most beautiful outside that we've been here for sure. There's some vibes as fuck right now. Holy, hold on, let's take a look at this. Ooh. Nice calm little day. I might take a fucking dip. Oh hell no, it's dirty right there. I'm not able to jump that far. Oh, I know why it's dirty down there. Holy.
he's taking a dip. All right, guys, so the gate's open for UFC 300 at 2 o'clock, but we're about 10 minutes late. I'm trying to put some pep in our set to make it a little bit less, because, you know, we want to get there early, and we need to get our Dana White seats. If you know, you know. We're here at New York in the park. That's what the sign says, at least. It also says T-Mobile Arena, baby. That means we're close. We're just putting some pep in our step, man. Jordan and I. Everybody else is falling behind, but...
that's shit.
This is where we got... Yeah, this is...
Anthony Smith, Fitzgerald, Michael Bisping. And... who was the last one? Anthony Lightheart. I think I forgot to say his name. It's pretty popping over here. Got a big line for like a UFC, I don't know. Some Bud Light promo. We're just about to go in right now, I think. All right, guys, we're here inside the T-Mobile Arena now, going to our seats. Had to slam a shot because, you know, the red tip of the fireball is sticking up the pocket, man. Oh, that shit was fucking warm and nasty, but, you know, it's probably the most tolerable liquor I've drank all weekend. Guys, we're trying to find our Dana White seats right now, if you know what I mean, so. But we're getting problems. We're having a little bit of problems. But Dana White busted with the seats for a reason, bro. He got us with the seats yesterday, and he got us with the seats today, man. Quit bullshitting. Guys, so we got our UFC bracelets. I got a tight mine, but this is fucking badass. Oh. We got our Dana White seats. So we're just here chilling. You know, shout out Dana White. Vibes are fucking lit, man. I only took one shot, but it didn't get me like feeling crazy, but it made me like a little bit loose. You know, I'm feeling a little bit more teed right now. I might slam another one, no chaser.
Yeah,
let's fucking go, baby.
We got
for later. I don't know if I showed this already, but we got some braces for UFC 300,
this is
bro.
Fire as fuck, bro.
I might cop some merch, I might not. Who knows? Same exact seats as last time, baby. Let's fucking go. I don't know how much time we have. Let me see. 30 minutes left until Cody Garbrandt versus Figgy. Maybe a little bit more if they're bullshitting, but I'm ready, man. And I need a chaser. I need like some Fanta. Or, I don't know. Sometimes it'll be fine. UFC 306 is on the weekend of my birthday, so we're spinning back to Las Vegas once again this year. You gotta hit at least 2 Vegas trips a year, I think. Right there in the middle, kind of, that bald head right above like the corner post. That's Uncle Dana right there, guys. Shout out to Uncle Dana for the seats.
Should see wristbands on your seats. Please put those on as you'll be part of some special effects during tonight's pay-per-view main card.
Oh, not for the main card?
Not for the main card, but fuck it. It's UFC drip for the free, so I'm aware. All right, guys, 1 minute until UFC 300 starts. Cody Garbrandt versus Davis Figueiredo. It's officially 3 o'clock, 300.
At 300.
UFC 300 starts at 300. Makes sense. Those edibles got me tired as fuck, man. But other than that, those edibles ain't shit. But man, I'm tired.
Unwavering belief, moments that defied errors. From one punch to the next, that made the world stop what it was doing.
This is an incredible display of courage and skill.
And share in the awe. Moments that sink the heart of a fighter at the beating heart of the fan.
Whoa! this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC Bantamweight division.
Fight ends in a second round submission. Biggie takes the back of Garbrandt. It was pretty good, actually, I'm not gonna lie.
What a performance tonight. 2 wins at Bantamweight in a row. A lot of people feel like this is the weight class you should have been at a long time ago. How good does it feel to be victorious here?
Hey, I'm glad it happened today. Thank you so much, guys. Hey, eu tô muito feliz, cara. I'm very happy today. Eu cheguei na categoria, agora eu quero.
I feel so good at this division, Dana. One shot of the belt, please. I need my shot.
Well, you made a statement tonight, sir. And with statements like that, that will leave you undeniable in terms of a shot at the title in the future.
That first round was good as fuck, I'm not gonna lie.
Bro, Hayden, this shit.
That was a one-sided beatdown, bro. That was bad. What do you think?
What a fucking fight, dude. That was good.
Oh my god, that was bad.
In that second round, you were really finding your rhythm. The second round was an absolute battle.
Hey! Listen up, I'm the poor black kid from the streets. I've been in 50 different homes. I got this business just to get a house. And there it is 10 years later, I own 4. Thank you, UFC, for blessing a poor black little kid like me.
I brought 4 generations of family tradition with 5 rulers. Huh? I want to make a few. Getting my business off the ground was a full-time job.
So I need one business anyway. I guarantee 100% accurate final and maximum. Make your moves all the way down. Aim to a triple tap. 100% accuracy guarantee.
Moicano versus
and
Curtis.
And after Moicano's last 2 wins.
Moicano needs to spin back to Bobby Green. Let's go, Moicano! Let's go! I just witnessed a fucking Jalen Turner. Oh my god, one of those punches landed on his face. One of those punches landed on his face. Here we fucking go again, man. Fucking 5-minute interview.
So, I'm not gonna do my speech, but first of all, I love America. I love the Constitution. I love carbon, property, and let me tell you something. If you care about your fucking country, read Ludwig von Mises and the 6th lessons of the Austrian Economic School, motherfuckers.
Diego Lopez and Sadiq Youssef right now.
I like both of them.
Diego Lopez. They need to fight more.
Oh, Kayla Harrison, you know, nothing right home by in the first round so far, but you know, I'm feeling pretty good. I can definitely slam a few more right now, but I'm gonna hold off Holly for a couple more fights.
All right, guys, Holly Holm versus Kayla Harrison. We got round one, round two finished. I'm like three, four shots deep. I don't know, but this is hitting way harder than I expected. And I'm feeling fucking good as shit right now. I'm talking to like the strangers next to me now. This is a good time right now. I got like three more shots, so I'm gonna see them for a little bit later. Then we're really crashing out. Oh, my stomach hurts!
I can't wait to see
it. It's not that bad, but like, damn. Who's next? I don't know. Oh, Aljamain Sterling versus Calvin Kattar. I don't give a fuck.
We're at Shake Shack right now because I'm hungry and I'm drunk, so we're just gonna have one burger, then we're gonna go to Dave's Hot Chicken later. So I'll let you guys know about this burger in a second. Yuri Prosser's walking out right now, but we're not about to record that because I'm waiting for my burger. I'm still in line, by the way. So, you know, fuck all that. Fucking $20 combo at a T-Mobile Shake Shack is crazy, man. Fuck that. I got a single double burger. All right, guys. I know I already did a Shake Shack review, but that shit was fire. I slammed that shit. All right, guys. The main event is about to start, man. We got the bracelets on. They just played a promotional video with Teenage Boyfriend. Let's go, baby.
There we go, baby.
Broad track! Let's go, Cody Brundage! Blanker during the Cody Brundage walk up, baby! This walkout song is ass! Cody Brundage knockout! Let's go! Alright guys, Cody Brundage versus Bo Nickel just ended in a submission. Cody Brundage just won. I'm about to boo the fuck out of him. Number one Bo Nickel hater right here. Charles Oliveira versus the Armitage Yukian. Let's go, Charles! What a fucking event, guys. You know, a lot of my fighters, you know, got shit on, but it was still good, bro. But fuck, man. Can't believe just in case you got did bad like that, bro. Now we're about to head to Dave's Hot Chicken and get some food. This is the scene outside the T-Mobile Arena post UFC 300. God damn, rest in peace, Justin Gaethje, man. That was fucked up. I did not have to see that, bro. I would have been better off not seeing that shit, to be honest. All right, guys. It's officially the last day of the trip. So we're about to leave right now, man. You know, I actually didn't get as drunk as I thought I was, but hey. I really don't mind because, you know, drinking's for little bitches. Fuck drinking. Look at this little puke baby over here. Fucking wearing puke fucking jacket right now.
Hey.
You know, so that's why I don't drink. You. That's why you don't drink, guys.
So, we're about to get some food at the motherfucking In-N-Out Burger. I had a fucking slider from goddamn Dave's Hot Chicken, but I fucking needed that bitch because somebody threw away my sauce, so I was not about to eat that shit without the sauce.
I also forgot to record the outro for this video because I'm retarded. But if you like the video, make sure you drop a like, comment, and share with somebody you know and somebody you don't know, man. Let's go.